Josh Sanderson is one of the newest members of the National Lacrosse League Hall of Fame. The Orangeville native played in the league for 19 seasons and finished fourth in the NLL for scoring. Today, we take a look back at his impressive career.
Pass behind the net. Connects there with Sanderson. Sanderson shakes off a check with five to shoot. Tries the shot, scores!
Josh Sanderson's career statistics are impressive. 484 goals, 973 assists, and 291 games played throughout his 19-season career, rightfully earning the nickname The Shooter.
I guess the Albany really fond memories of the people I played with. One memory would be losing to Toronto in the final would be a not-so-good memory, but that'd be one that started off, but it makes you stronger as your career goes on. Down the road, 2005 in Toronto, we were able to have some success.
He's a really competitive guy. Just wants to win, a great passion for the game of lacrosse, and, you know, the ultimate leader.
It's one of the things that was my dad built in me, that competitive spirit, and when we won, it was obviously fun, and you get to enjoy it with the team.
But what may have been more impressive than his statistics was that at 5'7", he played with heart, grit, and determination way beyond his size.
When you got a guy of his size out there battling like he has in this year in this league for 19 years, and laying his body on the line and leading by example, how do you not follow it?
For all the smaller players out there that are growing up in minor and junior, I'm hoping to be a bit of a role model there, and just if you work hard and do what you're good at, hopefully you get a chance to play at whatever level you can get to.
A quiet leader, but one that was respected by every teammate he played beside.
And Josh wasn't a guy that, said a lot. He always kind of liked to let his actions on the floor do the talking. Mm-hmm. And whenever Josh said something, everyone listened.
When he realized he could no longer play at the competitive level of the past, he put his stick down, but never stepped away from the sport he loves.
As the season went on, I just didn't feel I could do what I used to. I used to be have a little bit of quickness, and that was gone. So it was just time.
The things that people don't know, just coached two of his kids, before our season ended, just finished a couple weeks ago. I know he coached Team Ontario this year, coached one of the Junior Rock teams for me. All about giving back to a sport that has been such a big part of his life.
Josh now holds the role as the assistant general manager of the Toronto Rock, a role that he's emotionally connected to, as his father, Terry, was the GM of the team before his passing.
There's probably too many things to tell how much I learned from him, but definitely trying to get good people and character people was the biggest.
It is funny, there's a lot of times where I do see the old man sitting across from me, things he'll say or this and that, but so far so good, love the relationship, and I'm looking forward to the future.
And according to many that knew Josh as a player and a person, it was no surprise when he was announced to join the National Lacrosse League Hall of Fame.
Well, I wasn't shocked. I would have been more shocked if he wasn't. To me, he should have been on 100% of those ballots.
This happened pretty quick. It feels like I just retired a few months ago, because I basically did. So I was a little obviously honored and surprised, but I was like, holy, things are moving pretty quick here.
Let's pretend that it is the award night. What message do you have for Josh?
Enjoy it. Take a minute to really enjoy this. You deserve it. I know you don't like the spotlight and the this and the that, but you had a hell of a career. I think you paved the way for all the smaller people that ever played the game, and now you're back with the old man right beside him, right where you belong.